This is more of a story of Gerald McCloy, better known as Gerald McBoing Boing, the noise-making boy. For when he started talking, so it is said, he didn't speak words. He went boing, boing instead. His odd talent brought him fame throughout the nation. Gerald's popularity continued to...
Critics of the administration have suggested that the president is, quote, stalling for time, but informed sources at the White House reveal that the president is conferring with his staff on the matter. And now on the local scene, an elderly man was attacked and beaten by a group of unidentified assailants on the Lower East Gang.
Thank you. the day.
Hi, Harry.
Man, I gotta hide out here for a while. Rinaldi's been busting my chops all day.
Don't let it bug you.
Oh, God, it's hot. How do you work here?
You think this is hot?
Yeah.
When I was in the Army, I used to be a fireman. Every day, I'd shovel coal into 6 furnaces. 24 hours on, 48 hours off. But I didn't mind it. It didn't bug me. I could get away from the other duty. It's the same up here. It's my own little world. I live here. Hey, oh, man. I almost forgot. I saw something so beautiful, so fantastic today. Harry, instead of taking the train, I got off at 155th Street.
Pool room, you hang out here? This place is off limits to unauthorized personnel, you understand that? Just for this, tomorrow night, when they change the marquee, you're gonna stay late and polish every bulb. Now get out. Look, I don't want my boys hanging out here, you understand that? Huh?
Look, screw off, Rinaldi. This booth is off limits to you too, remember that.
First of all, it's Mr. Rinaldi. And if my boys are here, I'm gonna come and get him. What is a cigarette butt doing on the floor? There's no smoking here, you understand that? Just once I'd like to meet you when you're not in the Union.
Thank you. me agree with Dr. Masters.
There's a new survey that's just been published by the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare that says...
Now, I read that, and I...
Gentlemen.
They're constantly...
What we're missing is the point about...
That's another day, Dobbs. You get the gold. I didn't know anything. The men, they were turning against me.
Somebody has the Falcon. Yes, the Falcon. I'll turn Junior in, and then you can have the Falcon. I know you, Mr. Spade.
Yes, everybody knows me. Except the boys on the ship. They mutinied. Sob singing, skinny old maid. When I measured those strawberries, I knew there was a quart. When I took the sand out, I realized that the strawberries were...
Oh, for Christ's sakes, don't cry, Min. Ah, oh, Jesus, you know that I've got to get home and go to bed. And besides, Harry and I are going to play some pool, Min. Ah, oh, dear keepers.
You're all commies, I can tell. Dirty comancheros, if you're not wearing our green berets, you're our pink gulls. Wagons, haul down to the bottom of the pit with all of you.
Someday I'm gonna take an airplane all the way from St. Louis, across the Atlantic, over here to Orly Field in Paris. Which way to Ireland? You see Ireland down there? Can you tell me where Ireland is? All right, switch the tanks. Don't crash now, for the love of God. Holy God, there's the medal Father Duffy gave me. Father Duffy.
All right, you guys. I know I'm going back to Terra. Now, see here. I want you to take care of Miss Scarlet.
I know nothing about baby Mr. Red.
I don't care. You take care of her. All right, son of a gun, I'm going to Terra. You're not going to Terra, you silly old fool. You're going to take care of Miss Scarlet. Yes, sir.
I know nothing about babies.
Suck off.
Good night, Chucky. Have a nice evening.
Why, Sophie, you have a lot of nerve. Say good night, Stanley.
Good night, Stanley.
So long, Fritzy Dobbs.
Thank you. fall in. Who's missing here? You.
Unhappy with your attitudes and your appearances. Carpets are constantly a mess. I find numerous candy wrappers and cigarette butts on the floor. Remember, dirt is our enemy. Also, there's a lack of pride in your uniforms. Shoes are not polished. Look at that face. What, are you afraid of a razor? When'd you shave, last Thursday? You shave an hour before you come to work. That's when you shave. Look at that, dandruff. Know what I told you? Dandruff means dismissal, understand? Your hands, your fingernails, dirty. Did you ever see my fingernails? They're immaculate because of my training by the great managers of yesteryears. That's right. It was pride in the old days. Pride when the palace was a palace. Why, at 14 years of age, I was an usher. Even before 14. I was bringing coffee to projectionists, shining manager's shoes. At 16, I became a manager. That's right, 16 years of age. You guys, you gotta shape up. No more respect today. Take that smirk. What's so funny here? What are you laughing at? You got a job here. No one laughs in this theater. I tell you when to laugh, you understand? And another thing. I want disinfectant in each toilet bowl. No more than an ounce in each bowl. I'm coming in here tomorrow. I'm gonna have my breakfast on the men's room floor. And I want it just the way I want it. You gotta listen and learn. There's no telling how high you might climb. How much can I teach you? How much can I try with you guys? I want you to shape up. Buttons always immaculate, polished, every one of them.
Why aren't you on your way home?
Rinaldi kept me here so long.
Think.
He's killing me. Disagreement. He wants every day something. Change these boxes for these boxes. These are red boxes for green boxes. He's a terrible guy.
He's out of his freaking skull, that's why. Hey, Harry was telling me something before about you. Is it true that you were in films? In Czechoslovakia?
I used to be in 60 movie pictures.
60 movie pictures?
In Europe, mostly in Czechoslovakia. 11 of them, it was silent.
Wow. What films would I know them?
What films? Not that it's only in Czech language, not you don't know. But some funny pictures like Laurel and Hardy or something like you had.
But why did you come here?
Communists took over my theater, and I couldn't get a job. I escaped.
You escaped? How did you escape?
I arranged for a show, theatrical show, in the small border town, and I invited also all the border guard with wives. We were playing a show, and after first act was intermission. And during this intermission, I left. I was running to the border, and I escaped.
There was a British movie like that one time, where they were all in a Nazi concentration camp, and they put on a show. And while they were waiting during intermission, they escaped. Did you get your idea from that?
But it was a fiction in my case. It was really life. I escaped in costume, in makeup.
You must look pretty funny coming across the border in your costume. Yes, what were you playing in this?
We were playing our barnyard.
And what were you playing?
I played a rooster. In a
you
rooster
crossed
costume.
The borderline in a rooster yes, outfit?
Because I thought if some guards with... talk to me, I will say, I am mental case. I am going to work, mental case. Something like that.
Yeah.
Life is sweet. You see, everything is here.
Listen, let me have some sour lemon drops, huh?
No money. No money.
Thank you.
Did he pay for those lemon drops?
No.
What are you, the Red Cross? What, is there a flood here? People get free candy, free lemon drops here? Pay for the lemon drops. Put some more gumdrops over here. Keep it neat. Neat. I'll send you back to the old country. All right. How's the soda moving?
Not so good.
Well, tomorrow you put more salt in the popcorn, you'll sell more soda.
Unbelievable. Those people are running the show.
Don't you worry about it.
I'm gonna go play pool. I'll see you later.
Goodbye. Good night, Chuck.
Thank you. make it. How about it? Isn't that Chuck? Hey, Chuck, it's nice to see you.
It's a wonderful night for this, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
It's the world premiere of The Projectionist. It certainly is a thrill.
Well, it's a thrill to have you here,
Chuck. A lot
of
fun making it, you know.
You did have a lot of fun.
Oh, yes.
Well, how'd you get started in films? How'd you get started in motion pictures?
Well, I've always liked movies. Movies have always been a kick for me, you know. I spent most of my childhood in movies.
Right.
I remember as a kid going into a movie theater, seeing a plaque on the wall saying that when you enter these portals, you leave the cares of everyday life behind, you know?
Ah, that's a great thought.
So
isn't that a great thought?
Yeah. I spent most of my life in, well, my early days in film houses.
Uh-huh. Well, you heard that, folks. I think that's a first we've had. I think that's just sensational.
I've got to cut now. Because
Chuck, it's just been great having you.
I've got to get up to the booth and get this one underway.
Fine, Chuck. Nice having you with us. How about that? That was Chuck McCann. Lovely. All right. Okay, we're going to have some few other people here in just a little while.
By the way, Harry, prepare to lose, because Minnesota is going to take it. In fact, I could even take Paul Newman tonight.
Hey! Every time I set them up for you, I'll keep missing. Go ahead. You've been missing all your life. Hey. Finish the story about the broad.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that was nice. You should have seen it, Harry. It was just so beautiful. Tell you, it's like out of a movie. I don't know about you, but I'm thirsty. I'm gonna send out for a beer. You wanna say hello to Comrade Bite or?
It wasn't the planes that killed Kong. Beauty killed the beast.
I don't give a turd who killed him. Who's getting him out of here? It's been raining dandruff for an hour and a half. Blocking traffic from here to 34th Street.
Now you're gonna see some shooting.
Hi there. Are you the nice guy who always finishes last? Don't you think it's time you had some satisfaction? Why don't you start looking out for number one?
I'm not fighting for anything anymore except myself. I'm the only cause I'm interested in.
That's wonderful, sir, wonderful. I do like a man who tells you right after he's looking out for himself. Don't we all? I don't trust a man who says he's not.
What earthly good is it for me to teach that honesty is the best policy when all around I see that dishonesty is the better policy? The hoodlum and the gangster is looked up to with the same respect as the successful businessman or the popular hero.
Toast, Jedediah, to love on my terms. Those are the only terms anybody ever knows.
Job that has to be done. Something more important than you and me. Perhaps someday, when the world's a better place, we'll meet again. Go now. Goodbye, my love.
There is nothing that gives one such a sense of inner peace as humility. At the beginning,
Like in all of our endeavors, it is often difficult and extremely trying.
Good evening, friends. It's E. Eddie Edwards speaking on behalf of the fabulous Judeo-Christian good guy Kit. And I need no introduction to church-going people, no. I've been written up four separate times in ecclesiastical magazines, and they say, now hear me please, that there can be no real goodness without self-denial, self-sacrifice, and pain. And as you remember, we brought you the fabulous Judeo-Christian golden rule, and millions of you have that in the privacy of your own homes, and what you do there, friends, that's nobody's business but your own. And today we have a fabulous three-piece merchandise offering I think you're going to be very pleased with. You've got pain, self-denial, and self-sacrifice right here laid out for you. Here's what you get. Item number one, a fabulous set of flesh pinchers. You see that? Awfully designed to pinch any part of your body. You can use them alone, use it with a friend, a relative, a neighbor. Wait a minute. Use that with hubby. He'll thank you for it the longest day you live. For a special treat, just heat up the edges, make them nice and hot. By golly, there's one you like. Item number two, a fabulous, fabulous whip. The same type of whip found all through the Holy Bible, and friends, has been mentioned 17 separate times, and they say there's nothing like a good flogging or birching. Friends, you'll get used to that item. And here's the big one. Yes, it's stocks and bondage, friends. You can have it in hard or soft wood, dark or light wood, mahogany, maple, lime, oak, hardwood, cherry, orange, lemon, or lime. And for those who write today, here's what you're going to get absolutely free. We'll call this one free gift number one. Isn't that wonderful? Say yes, it makes me feel good. You see, that's a petition pad, friends, 365 pages thick, one petition for a worthwhile cause every single day of the year. And for those people who write the first 100, I'm going to send you absolutely free of any charge a special gift, the wonderful Judeo-Christian Brotherhood poster. And friends, brotherhood is a great Christian ethic. Now, friends, this is almost as good as having a darkie for a friend or a companion. Except this poster will never riot, break, or burn, and by golly, he'll never marry your sister, no. Now, friends, ordinarily you'd expect to spend $19.95 for this fabulous three-piece set, and it's worth every penny of it. Now, hear me, please. But we're going to take that $19.95 price today. We're going to leave it aside. We're going to throw it out the window. We're going to charge you a special price, not of $19.95, but of $39.95, because it's better to give more than you receive. And now, friends, while we're going to flash those telephone numbers on the screen where you can place your orders, but before we do that, I'd like you to watch and see what's going to happen to you when you buy the fabulous Judeo-Christian Good Guy Kit. Watch.
Good morning. Thank you. and grief. But you know what? You can build and you can destroy. Look at the man-made. Man-made sidewalks. Man-made buildings. Man-made atomic bombs. Man-made everything, aeroplanes, equipment. But there's one thing they can't reach, and that is the sky and heaven. But God said he was ever sorry he created the world.
In the beginning, life is born in the waters. One form of living thing evolves into another until at last, man emerges. Convinced of his superiority over the rest of the animal kingdom, he uses his intellect to carry out the primeval lusts he has inherited from his simian ancestors. Animal urges rationalized by a sophisticated intelligence drive him into acts of brutality and folly unparalleled in the history of the world.
Lord! What fools these mortals be!
Seduced by his brain to seek the things his animal body is incapable of achieving, man inevitably moves on to greater folly.
You know where the river is? The river that goes under the ocean. God, man made that under the ocean for you to get to New York. Well, let me tell you, dear generation, you better get married now because the world is coming to an end. The world is coming to an end. Men can destroy. As long as a man is a president, he'll destroy. We cannot change men.
How are you? Have a nice night?
You know, Rinaldi, he's still bothering me.
That's because you're not putting enough salt in the popcorn.
He didn't try.
Give me the chair right there. Yeah.
Hey, listen.
I see.
How's the soda moving today?
Nothing.
No good, huh?
No good.
I better turn down the air conditioning. Then. Do something.
Hey, Harry.
Okay, what's the worry?
Oh, man. Harry, you're not gonna believe it. Not in a million years. I tell you, it was so wild, Harry. She lives on 57th Street. She's got a beautiful pad. She invites me up, see? I knock on the door. I figure I'm gonna go for coffee with her. So simple, the rest was history.
Wow. You're a champ. Thank you.
Thank you.